Good morning, Pen to Parliament Forum. I'm Sabally for the youths. Greetings. This is your brother Momodou Sabally. It's been a while. Just thought I should come and say hello and chat a little bit. Greetings to everybody in the forums here. Kablandao, Bais Cham, Omar Sanyang and Co. Saluto Abalbe. You know, I greet you all. Well, as you know, it's a tough world we live in these days. You know, things are really crazy all over the world. It's war, privation, and other calamities. But, you know, we know things are tough here, and without a doubt, that's true. But the Gambia situation is much worse. Inflation, I understand, in Senegal is around about 6% or so. In the Gambia, it's double. We're hitting 12%. So whatever is happening in the world is doubled here because of the incompetence and lack of patriotism, lack of vision, lack of empathy, lack of sympathy for the young people and the women. That's what's exacerbating every situation in this country right now under the clueless leadership of President Barrow, who has infected us with Barrowflation. And as I told you guys earlier, Barrowflation is what? It's a hyperinflation, rising costs of basic commodities, crime, the free entry and exit of hard drugs in the country by people who are seen to be close to the powers that be, and they get scot-free, but the young people will get hunted by the drug squad into the little streets and corner ghettos just for a joint or a box, when the real importers of hashish from Morocco go scot-free. That's what's happening in this country, and really it's a recipe for disaster. Things are getting worse by the day. I mean, like I said, there's a global macroeconomic disturbance, but everything that's happened in this country has doubled. And the fact is, our economy started suffering even before this Ukraine war, because now President Barrow, even if you tell him that there is a football match and Gambia has lost a penalty, he says, yeah, it's because of the war in Ukraine and Russia. I mean, come on, it's balderdash. You know, the reality is that Ahmad Ba destroyed the tourism industry before coronavirus, before the Ukraine war. After all this corona thing, UN pumped in millions of dollars. They took away all the money, gave the boys chicken change. Even before that, with this all-inclusive, the tourism industry has been bulldozed by the greedy, powerful people within the industry. I mean, how can you have hotel owners be board members of a tourism board? Where will be the justice for the waitresses, for the waiters, for the housekeepers, for the tourist guides? Everything is gone all-inclusive. The money comes. No, the money doesn't even reach the country any longer. It goes into the accounts of the powerful hotel owners in Europe and America. I mean, what's going to happen? They've increased the taxes at the ports, port charges, import duties. Of course, the prices of goods and services are going to be high. And that's why, mainly because government is spending more than necessary. If you have to build a road for $1 million, they'll make it $2 million. The contractor gets the $1 million, the other $1 million gets shared between the ministers and the directors within the system. You know, this is what's complicating the whole economic situation in this country. And things are going to get worse. So I'm warning you guys, like I said before, I mean, fasten your seatbelts. This country is going to get crazier. If you look at the headlines in this country now, I mean, it just shows you that things are not going right. The other day, I saw a headline, the Afro Barometer did a survey. What is the conclusion? Survey highlights poor government impact on Gambian youths. This government is doing nothing for the young people of this country. After all the money we paid in taxes of more than $100 billion over the past 5 years, young people themselves saying, this is not Momodou Sabally. This is a survey asking people how they feel, asking the youth of this country how they feel about government services. The survey concludes poor government impact on Gambian youths. They appoint a minister of youth, directors of youth. What are they doing? Traveling left, right, and center. You know, procurement fraud, the scorpions were supposed to come back. What happened? The money, nobody knows where it went out, west or north. The whole flight arrangement flopped because of corruption. And what happened? The scorpions were stranded in Cameroon. They could not even give these young people the opportunity to give a hero's welcome to Momodou Barrows, Moussa Laka Barrows, the street travelers. They could not even give us the opportunity to welcome our people because of procurement fraud, corruption, and recklessness in this government. This is what's happening. You look at the headlines today, the price of bread is gone, $12, this government is complaining. What are you complaining? You destroyed the economy, so inflation will rise. The price of bread is going to reach more than $20 before the end of the year. Mark it in your diaries, it's going to happen. And that's why I said we should fasten our seat belts. Pura, on the same headline, is saying that only 33.8% of Gambian households have access to safe drinking water. What a shame. What a disaster. What a disappointment that this government that said EU gave them more than €1 billion, and even Barrow himself, he said, even the mice and the cats will enjoy. You cannot give even half of the population safe, clean drinking water. We are not asking for gold or diamond. We are not asking for milk. Safe drinking water for our children. This government cannot give us that. And we'll allow these people to continue to lead us. You know, it is our responsibility to organize, to mobilize, to get ready, to make sure that we kick this government out of power by all legal democratic means necessary. And this is what should be in the mind and heart of every ghetto youth right now, because the situation is going to get worse and worse and worse. And it is you, the young people, who will suffer the most. You know, but we cannot sit down in the ghettos, you know, drinking attire, you know, just complaining in the little corners. No, we got to organize. We got to mobilize. We got to come into groups. We got to be a little bit more active. We got to hold the powers that be accountable, because we're giving them our taxes. They owe us services. They owe us explanations when things don't go right. But that will not happen until we stand up and get up and ask for those questions and answers. Nobody is going to come into this country to solve these problems for us. It is our responsibility. And we have to get up and stand up, as Bob Marley would ask us to do. And stand up for our rights, because government will never give us this on a silver platter. It's our right. When we give them the taxes, if you don't pay taxes, you go to jail for it. If you pay taxes, those who steal the taxes should go to jail. That's what should happen. Those who mismanage the taxes should be voted out of office, so we get better leadership in this country that would be a leadership of vision, that would care about the plight of the young people. A leadership that will not sign deportation agreements with the West. A leadership that will not allow cocaine importers to go scot-free and go for the poor ghetto youths for their joints and backs is completely unacceptable. Yeah. It's not going to happen. God is not going to come down. We will have to get up. We will have to stand up for our rights. It is our right. Yes. It is our right to get good services, to get proper employment, to get good clean drinking water, to get stable electricity that we are paying for our cash power, but the power goes off. Barrow said 19 times, now it goes 50 times a night. Completely unacceptable, completely deplorable, completely condemnable, unacceptable. Thank you. It's your brother, Momodou Sabally, saluting you all. Pen to Parliament, M. Sabally for the youths, all the ghetto youths of this country, I salute you all. Thank you. Don't give up the fight.